Hello friends, now we'll see the basic concept of C++, where we'll see the keyboards, literals, variables and constant in C++. So let's start with the keywords. Basically, what do you mean by keywords? Keywords are the reserve words. Reserve words means the words which are already explained to the compiler, which are already fixed with the compiler, and the meaning of those words are already defined to the compiler. That means you cannot specify the different meaning to those names because compiler has already known those words. Like, one has to design a set of instructions to be used for communicating with the computer to carry out the specific operations. And those set of instructions are called as the keywords. Basically, in C++, we are having total 48 keywords, which are reserve words. Means the words which are already defined by the compiler. Which are they? These all are the 48 keywords which are already defined to the compiler. In that, the first is ASM, case, const, delete, auto, bool, char, double we have seen already, then int we have seen already, then char we have seen already, then public we have seen already, plus I'll say struct we have seen already. So those float we have seen already. So those are some constant keywords are present in C++, and those word you cannot assign to your another programming statements. Next we'll start with the identifiers. Identifier, as a name suggests, that identity given to the particular value. Identity means, consider you are giving a particular name to your memory location, or we can say a particular name to your method. So those identity is called as identifier. For example, identifier is a name assigned to a function, variable or any other user defined item. Identifier can be from several characters long. There are certain rules to define particular identifier. The first rule to declare any identifier is, variable name must start with any letter, alphabet or underscore. And then you can come with a letter, digit or underscore. For example, I can say student underscore ID. This is a valid identifier. But if you are writing one stud, that is a wrong identifier, or underscore stud ID, that is also wrong identifier. Next rule is, uppercase and lowercase are distinct. That means if you are writing student in small letter and if you are writing stud ID in capital letter, so both will get considered as a different variables. Next rule is, keywords cannot be used. That means, right, total 48 keywords we have learned. For example, if you want to give your variable name as consider if, so that will give you error. Or I can say, if you are giving the variable name or identifier name as a char, that will be error. Next topic is variable. Now, variable means what? Variable means a name given to the memory location. That means whatever data you are storing in the memory location, you are using that data, and you are using that data with the help of that name. And that name is called as a variable. Now we'll see. Variable is a name, area in the memory used to store the values during program execution. Variables are runtime entity. Yes, Variable has a symbolic name and it can be a variety of values. That means if you specify the variable name as a 10 for the first time and you can vary that data for the next time, you can make it as 11. Okay? That means whatever data you are storing inside the memory, that can be getter varied. That's why the name of that memory location is variable. Next, when a variable given the value is actually placed in the memory space. And all variables must be declared before they can be used. The basic syntax of the variable is data type and variable name. That means first you have to specify that what type of data you are storing. It may be integer, it may be character, it may be float, any type of data you can store, and the name, particular name to that variable. That name you have to follow with the identifier rules. If you are not following it, you will get an error for those variable names. Now, the syntax, or we can say the example for the variable is, I'll say int, this is the data type of my variable, I is my identifier name, equal to 10. So I can say, this is my data type, this is my variable name, with I'm assigning the value as 10. Next, we'll see the constant. Constant is similar as a variable, but the values of those constants are fixed. That means whatever data you are storing in the memory location, if you don't want to change those values, you have to store that variable name as a constant. Now, how you can do that? You can do it with the help of the keyword, that is const. Yes, const. For example, const, the data type, variable name and the value. Now, whatever value you are storing with that variable name is called as a literal. The term is literal. That means whatever value you are giving to your variable name, that is called as literal. For example, const float pi equal to 3.14. Now, the keyword const will specify that that type of data is a constant. Float is a data type which will specify that the data which you are storing in the pi variable is floating type. Pi is a variable name which will tell you the variable location. And with the help of 3.14, I am assigning the literal value to the variable pi. Next comes is enumeration or enumerated type. Enumeration type. Enumeration is basically the type with the help of that you can provide the constant values. And with the help of that you can get the constant data. Means whatever data you are saving in the enum, that will be constant. Wherever you want, the list of data will be available with the same values. Now we'll see. Enumeration is a type which declares an optional type used as a value of the type. Each enumeration is requires the use of keyword enum. Without the keyword enum, you cannot declare any data as an enum. Next, syntax of enumeration is enum, enum name, list of the names, and the variable list. Means with the help of enum keyword, we are saying that this type of data is enumeration. Next is enum name. That means I am saying that whatever the variable name will be. And this enumeration list having different names. That means whatever data I am storing over here, that will be constant. For example, enum color red, green, blue equal to C. That means enum is a class which having a name as a color and it's having different color as a red, green and blue. And if I want to access this data, I have to use a variable name, that is C. Means the C will have the first value as a blue, green and red. Thank you so much.